Do you ever have trouble sleeping or feel like you slept but it didn't do anything because you're just tired all day? Well, then this video is for you. Hi, I'm Dr. Chris Masterjohn of chrismasterjohnphd.com, and you're watching Chris Masterjohn Lite, where the name of the game is details, schmeetails. Just tell me what works. And today we're going to be talking about basic principles of light hygiene for better sleep at night and better wakefulness during the day. The way that we do that is we need to convince our brains that it's daytime when it really is, and that it's nighttime when it really is. And the problem is that the signal that our brains use to know the difference is blue light. And in the great outdoors, it's always been really bright during the day and really dark at night. In our modern lifestyles, not true. In the daytime, we're indoors where it's less bright, and then in the nighttime, we turn on lights to make it more bright. And so we've taken that night and day differential and shrunk it down to the point where our bodies don't know the difference. And if our bodies don't know the difference, then our bodies can't prepare to do the things that need to be done when we're sleeping to maximize the rest we get out of that sleep. And can't prepare to do the things that we need to do when we're awake to maximize our alertness and wakefulness during the day. So how do we get around that? Well, fortunately, there are a few tweaks that we can make to our lifestyles in order to reconstruct a natural rhythm of light. Number one, get outdoor sunshine every morning for about a half hour at a consistent time each day. For me, I take a half hour walk outdoors between 9 and 10 a.m. That depends on when you wake up in the morning and when you start your day. Find what works for you, but make it a consistent schedule of morning sunshine. Number two, for the 2 to 4 hours before bed, block blue light. How do we block blue light? Well, I use this light bulb for ambient lighting from lowbluelights.com. It's bright enough that it allows me to read a book, and yet emits low enough blue light that it doesn't interfere with my sleep. There's also blue blocking glasses, like these Solar Shield Fitsover or these Swanies. And these are great because you can go into any other kind of lighting. Maybe you don't have control over the ambient lighting and you can block that, filter that blue light out. But they're kind of dark, so it's hard to read with those without straining your eyes. If you're trying to create 2 to 4 hours of blue blocking, it's important to be consistent. So, for example, if you're reading by the ambient light and then you go to the refrigerator because you realized you needed a sandwich, and all of a sudden for 30 seconds you blast yourself with bright blue light, what was the point of the 2 hours of blue blocking if now all of a sudden you're going to tell your brain, hey, it's daytime out again? So, it's important to piece together any kind of routine that would work for you to make 2 to 4 hours of consistent, solid blue blocking time. I also use a nightlight and a flashlight from lowbluelights.com to help round out that blue blocking at night. Now, the third principle is that this has to be consistent at the same time every night. If you're deliberately trying to sleep 5 hours during the week and make up for it with 12 or 13 hours in the weekend, that lack of consistency is going to undermine your efforts. If you don't fall asleep at the same time every night, that's fine. If you make your light routine consistent each day, that's going to help establish a pattern that will eventually train your body to get tired around the same time every night and to wake up around the same time every morning. All right, I hope these tips were helpful for you. Signing off, this is Chris Masterjohn of chrismasterjohnphd.com. You've been watching Chris Masterjohn Lite, and I'll see you in the next video.